A very good afternoon, class. So as you all know, we are continuing with the third chapter of our secretarial practice, and the topic that we are covering is issue of shares. So class, yesterday, if you have gone through the videos, I had given you all a brush up regarding all the topics which we have covered in the chapter. So today, class, the topic which we'll be starting on, the name of the topic is transfer of shares. This topic already we have studied so many times during different chapters, and also last year we have covered all these topics, like the topics which we started yesterday, that is forfeiture of shares, surrender of shares, transfer of shares and transmission of shares. So class, basically today our focus will be only on the topic transfer of shares. So pay attention when I'm teaching, and we are starting with the meaning of transfer of shares. So transfer of shares basically means the voluntary transfer of shares by a member of the company in favor of another person. So it is a voluntary decision taken by the member. There is no force, there is no pressure, nobody forces him to do. He willingly takes the decision to transfer the shares in favor of another person. The transfer may be done by the member in the consideration or give away as a gift. So it can be done on the basis of just selling purpose and earning money, or it may be given away as a gift. Now, in case of public company, this we studied last year, that the shares are freely transferable in nature. There is no restrictions on the transfer of shares. But as far as a private company is concerned, there are certain restrictions on the transfer of shares. The shares cannot be freely transferable. Now, the person who is doing the transfer is called as the transferor, and the person to whom the transfer is made is called as the transferee. So basically, I'll give you an example over here. So consider that Mr. A has some shares of the company and he wants to transfer those shares to another person, say Mr. B. So in this case, the holder of the shares of the company here, A, is called as the transferor because he is planning to give away his shares or transfer his shares to Mr. B. And in this case, Mr. B, to whom the transfer is being made, he or she can be called as the transferee. So these are the two parties to the transfer of shares. So moving forward to the next line. Now, transfer of shares involve a certain procedure, a certain process the person has to go through. So what is the process? The member has to apply to the company by filling the instrument of transfer, along with submitting the share certificate and the transfer fees. So basically here, what happens is the member first fills the instrument of transfer form. And with that, he also has to submit the share certificate and the transfer fees, whichever is required. Now what happens is the member can sell either part of the shares or full of his shares. The decision lies with the member. Now transfer is said to be complete only when it is registered in the register of members. So class, as we saw that when all these procedure is a legal procedure, correct? So after filing of allotment of shares, as we saw previously in the allotment of shares, the secretary has to file it with the registrar of companies. Only when the registration is complete, then the register of members is made, and on that basis the share certificate is issued. So similarly, the transfer is said to be complete only when, instead of Mr. A, Mr. B's name should appear in the register of the members. So when Mr. B ka naam wo register mein dikhega, then only we can say that the transfer is complete. So that is one of the important points you have to keep in mind. Under depository system, it automatically gets transferred on delivery against payment. So when the transfer of shares is made electronically, that time the, you know, it automatically gets transferred. So there is no such procedure you have to go through. All this procedure is done in case of physical transfer of shares that we are seeing. So if it is done under depository system, that is with the help of electronic mode, then it automatically gets transferred on delivery against payment. So that is the C. Moving forward with the transfer of shares, stamp duty has to be paid on the physical transfer of shares, but in case if the shares are transferred in electronic mode, that is in DMAT form, then the stamp duty is not required to be paid. Now, what is physical transfer of shares? Physical transfer of shares ka matlab hota hai, a transfer deed, a transfer agreement has to be made by going to the court. Okay, then after going to the court, there are certain formalities to be fulfilled. So in all that cases, when a transfer deed has to be made in a paper format, you know, we require the hard copy of it, that time a stamp duty has to be paid. Now, class, you must have gone through these words so many times, and also in your accounts, in your final accounts, you must have heard words like octroi, freight charges, custom duty. So what is these duties all about? A stamp duty is nothing but this is a tax which is payable to the central government when the transfer deed is executed. So basically, these duties are nothing but a tax which we have to pay to the government, because all this is a legal procedure, right? And for this, you require lawyers, the court, which will not do the work for free. So this is a form of tax which you pay to the government when the transfer deed is executed. As per the Indian Stamp Act 1899, the stamp duty is 0.25% of the market value of the shares as on the date of execution of the transfer. So in order to understand this, I have written a small example. So pay attention. Now, for example, if Mr. A is transferring shares worth rupees 1000 to Mr. B, then the stamp duty which will be required to pay would be 1000 rupees into 0.25%, that is 2.50 rupees. So this is the additional amount, the additional stamp duty apart from the transferring of the shares which and the transfer fees which Mr. A has to pay. So this is what the stamp duty means. So I hope the meaning is clear to you all. So up till now, whatever we studied, is it clear? Okay. Now, this particular slide shows us the procedure for share transfer. Now, class, this particular thing is not mentioned in your textbook, but I felt that this topic is also important. At least you should know the procedure, how the share transfer is made. So for your extra knowledge, I have just inserted an extra topic in your this thing topic, that is the procedure for share transfer. Now, stage one. Number one, presentation of the transfer deed. So basically, a transfer deed is to be made, and it can be made by the any person who wants to, who wishes to transfer his shares to some other person, and for that he will require a legal authority, as we saw. So the prescribed authority is none other than the registrar of companies, who will help him out to make the transfer deed. Stage number two. So the registrar of companies helps in making the transfer deed. So whatever entries are to be made, formalities are to be done, he helps the person out. He makes the transfer deed, and then he puts the stamp and date on it when the transfer deed is made and can be executed. So that time the sign of both the transferor and the transferee is being taken, and all the other entries and formalities are completed. Now, what is the time limit for deposit of the transfer deed? Now, it is different for different companies. In case if your company is a listed company, in that case, you have two options. That is the first closure of the register of members and date of stamping plus 12 months. That is a year's time you get. But if your company is unlisted one, in that case, the date of stamping plus 2 months will be your time limit for depositing the transfer deed with the company. Now, once the transfer deed is made and deposited with the company will go through the transfer deed. Also, at this particular time, the transferee has to obtain the notice as well as no objection letter also from the registrar of companies. So once the registrar of companies has helped the transferor and the transferee, after depositing the transfer deed with the company, the transferee also has to get the notice period for it, the notice letter, as well as no objection certificate letter, which it has to again give it to the company of which it is buying the shares from Mr. E. So after receiving all the documents from the transferee and the transferor, the company can decide whether it has to accept the transfer of the shares or refuse the transfer of the shares. If the company accepts the transfer of the share, then you can see the effect of transfer of shares as the issue and share certificate will be delivered to Mr. B, and also the changes will be made in the register of the members. So in place of A, Mr. B's name will be entered in the register of the members, and Mr. B will be issued and delivered the share certificate. But sometimes the company refuses the transfer of shares. Now, what are the conditions under which the company refuses the transfer of shares? That is our next topic. That is refusal of transfer of shares. Now, sometimes the board of directors refuses the transfer of shares. The conditions for this may be given as under. Number one, the provisions given in the Articles of Association for transfer of the shares is not fulfilled. Now, there are certain conditions mentioned. There are certain provisions to be satisfied for making the transfer of shares. If those provisions are not satisfied, then the board of directors refuse the transfer of shares by the member. Second, as we saw, the person has to fill the instrument of transfer, correct? So the instrument of transfer is not as per the Companies Act 2013. आपने भर तो दिया इंस्ट्रूमेंट ऑफ ट्रांसफर, बट जैसा कंपनीज एक्ट में बोला गया है वैसे मैच नहीं कर रहा है. सो एट दैट पर्टिकुलर टाइम द बोर्ड ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स विल रिफ्यूज द ट्रांसफर ऑफ शेयर्स. अगेन वी सॉ व्हेन द पर्सन इज फिलिंग द इंस्ट्रूमेंट ऑफ ट्रांसफर, उसको अपना शेयर सर्टिफिकेट और ट्रांसफर फी भरनी होती है. इन दिस केस इंस्ट्रूमेंट ऑफ ट्रांसफर इज नॉट सपोर्टेड बाय द शेयर सर्टिफिकेट. So at that particular time, the board of directors will refuse the transfer of shares. The company has lien on shares to be transferred. Now class, remember this word lien on shares. This also we had studied last year. So in order to understand what is the meaning of lien on shares, here's the next slide. I present it in front of you. So what is the meaning of lien on shares? Lien on shares is nothing but a legal order which prohibits a partner or a member from selling or transferring his shares or interest in the company until his debts or liabilities to the company have been satisfied. So basically, lien on shares ka matlab hai, jo member shares transfer karne ka soch raha hai, us particular bande pe company ke kuch debts hai, liabilities hai, which the person has not cleared up till now. So that is the meaning of the fourth point. Company has lien on shares. So iska matlab hai, until and unless the person clears his debts or liabilities which is there of the company on him, he cannot transfer or sell his shares. Us time pe board of directors refuse kar denge us particular bande ka shares transfer karne ko. So is lien on shares clear? So it is nothing but a legal order that the person cannot sell or transfer the shares because he has to clear his debt or liabilities first, which is there of the company on him. Again, continuing the refusal of transfer of shares, the board of directors has a right to refuse the transfer of shares, and a notice regarding such with reasons should be sent to the member or the members within 30 days from the date on which the company received the instrument of transfer. So we saw the reasons why the board of directors refused the transfer of the shares. So regarding that issue, the company has to issue a notice, okay, and send it to the member with the proper reason given within 1 month from the date of receiving the instrument of transfer. But if in case agar koi notice nahi aaya to kya kar sakte hain? A member may appeal to NCLT. Class, remember these were the organizations which we studied last year, correct, which helps the company in the legal procedure. So NCLT was National Company Law Tribunal. So the member can make appeal to this particular thing, NCLT, against the refusal by the board within 30 days from the date of receipt of refusal notice. So, अगर बंदे को लगता है कि नहीं कंपनी ने रिफ्यूज कर दिया है मेरा ट्रांसफर ऑफ शेयर्स का अपील, सो ही कैन मेक एन अपील टू एनसीएलटी विद इन 30 डेज आफ्टर रिसीविंग द नोटिस. बट इन केस कोई नोटिस ही नहीं मिला बंदे को और स्टिल कंपनी ने रिफ्यूज कर दिया है कि हम तेरा ट्रांसफर ऑफ शेयर्स रोक देंगे, सो इन दैट केस देयर आर टू ऑप्शंस. अगर नोटिस नहीं मिलता है देन इफ इट इज अ प्राइवेट कंपनी द मेंबर कैन अपील विद इन 60 डेज एंड इन केस इफ इट इज अ पब्लिक कंपनी द मेंबर कैन अपील विद इन 90 डेज ऑफ रिफ्यूजल. तो जब रिफ्यूज हो चुका है उसका डिमांड और नोटिस नहीं मिला है उसको क्यों रिफ्यूज हुआ है रीजन बताया नहीं गया है, he can appeal within 2 months in case if it is a private company and 3 months in case if it is a public company. So clear, under some circumstances the refusal of transfer of shares takes place. So is the topic clear, meaning of transfer of shares and why there is refusal of transfer of shares? Okay, now there are two types of share transfers which are given. Now share transfers is done basically and they are of two types. Number one, blank transfers, and number two, forged transfer. So let us see both these one by one. Number one, blank transfer. Blank means khali. So what exactly it means? When the member signs the instrument of transfer without filling the name of the transferee and hands it over to the transferee with the share certificate, it is called as blank transfer. So basically form bharte samay transferee ke jagah pe naam nahi likha jata, usko blank chhod diya jata hai. And aap jis bande ko transfer kar rahe us bande ko aapko instrument of transfer aur aapka share certificate thama dete, and you form that instrument and you sign that instrument of transfer. That particular thing is called as a blank transfer. It is as good as a blank check. है ना? मतलब हम उसमें पे किसको भर रहे उसका नाम नहीं लिखते, वो ब्लैंक छोड़ देते, खाली अमाउंट भरते, साइन कर देते. तो जिस बंदे को हम दे रहे वो बंदा अपना नाम उधर भर के चेक को एनकैश करा सकता है. So that is what is the meaning of blank transfer. So I repeat it again, when the person signs the instrument of the transfer and does not write the name of the transferee on it but gives to the transferee with the share certificate, so wo kaisa transfer ho jata hai, blank transfer. The blank transfer enables easy purchase and sale of the shares, as the blank transfer form can be sold any number of times. The intermediate buyers need not pay the stamp duty, and the holder of the blank transfer enjoys all the rights as a member is entitled to have. So unko basically whether the name is not mentioned in the transfer, but yes, to whom it is being transferred, jis bande ke paas wo form hai, share certificate hai, they will enjoy all the rights as a member whichever Mr. A used to enjoy. तो अभी मिस्टर बी के पास ट्रांसफर हो गई है वो सारी राइट्स. सो फॉलोड क्लास, व्हाट इज अ ब्लैंक ट्रांसफर? इट्स वेरी इजी. कमिंग टू फॉर्ज्ड ट्रांसफर, फॉर्ज्ड का मतलब बोगस. बोगस मींस फेक, झूठा, इलीगल. सो द सिग्नेचर ऑफ द ट्रांसफरर इज फॉर्ज्ड, बोगस और फेक और इलीगल. सो बेसिकली व्हेन यू आर ट्रांसफरिंग द शेयर्स, जो डॉक्यूमेंट पे आपके साइन चाहिए होते, जो बंदा ट्रांसफर कर रहा है, द सिग्नेचर्स इज नॉट मैचिंग, इट इज फ्रॉड, इट इज फॉर्ज्ड, इट इज फेक, झूठा है, इलीगल है. सो सच ट्रांसफर्स आर कंसिडर्ड टू बी इनवैलिड वेयर इन द सिग्नेचर ऑफ द ट्रांसफरर इज नॉट मैचिंग विद द ओरिजिनल वन. द कंपनी शुड नॉट रजिस्टर सच टाइप ऑफ ट्रांसफर ऑफ शेयर्स बिकॉज ये इलीगल है, फेक है, बोगस है. सो द कंपनी शुड नॉट रजिस्टर सच टाइप ऑफ ट्रांसफर्स. ओके, सो विद दिस क्लास द ट्रांसफर ऑफ शेयर्स टॉपिक गेट्स ओवर. आई होप यू विल हैव फॉलोड एंड अंडरस्टूड द टॉपिक. टुमारो विल बी टेकिंग अप द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, दैट इज ट्रांसमिशन ऑफ शेयर्स. टिल देन keep studying, keep practicing, stay safe and take care. Thank you so much, class, for listening to me. We stop here.